In this video, we are going to solve a limit problem from Chinese College Math Computation. First, let's put down the trig identity that we are going to use. That is a tangent alpha plus beta. Then just equals tangent alpha plus tangent beta. Then whole divided by 1 minus tangent alpha times tangent beta. Okay, now let's get started with our question. So the question is, find the limit as n goes to infinity of a tangent, so inside pi over 4 plus 1 over n, then to the power of n. First, let's apply this formula. So now here we have tangent pi over 4 plus tangent 1 over n. Then the bottom, 1 minus tangent pi over 4. Then times tangent 1 over n. Then raise the power of n. So now let's simplify. Because tangent pi over 4 is 1. So that's why this one is 1, this one is 1. So here just 1 plus tangent 1 over n. Then the bottom here, 1 minus tangent 1 over n. Then before we continue, let's recall a result. So that is the limit as x goes to 0, sine x over x equals 1. So now let's see, what is the limit as x goes to 0 of a tangent x over x? Because a tangent just sine over cosine. So we put a sine x here, then put a cosine x here. Then here put a 1, then x put down here. Based on this result, as x goes to 0, so sine x over x goes to 1, so this one goes to 1. So this one is a 1 over cosine 0. So then here, just 1 times 1 over cosine 0. This one is 1. So the answer is 1. So we have the limit as x goes to 0, tangent x over x is 1. Okay, then from here, we have the following result. So that is the limit as n goes to infinity, then tangent 1 over n, then over 1 over n. Because as n goes to infinity, 1 over n goes to 0, so here also goes to 0. Then based on this result, so then this one just equals 1. So then from this result, so the limit tangent 1 over n over 1 over n is 1. So then we can say the following. So we have the following result. Okay, so that's just tangent. So that means 1 over n is an equivalent infinitesimal of a tangent 1 over n. So that means we use 1 over n to replace tangent 1 over n. Then we can do it here and here. So we can use 1 over n to replace here and here. So now let's continue this equal sign. So then here we have, just continue. So the limit, then here just 1 plus 1 over n. Here 1 minus 1 over n. The whole thing to the power n. Now let's both top and bottom times n. So then here we have n plus 1, then here n minus 1. So now let's rewrite the inside part. So we're going to do top. So n here, we minus 1. Because here's minus, then we plus 1. So here's just 0. Then just plus 1. Then next, we are going to separate the inside into two parts. So then here, we're going to separate from here. So that is 1 plus 2 over n minus 1, then to the power n. So then next, so we're going to rewrite the exponent. So here, just 1 plus 2 over n minus 1 here. Then here we're going to put here, put this way, n minus 1 over 2. So here's a 2, here's 2. Then the outside. So outside here, we're going to put a 2 here. So the exponent down here is n minus 1. So you see, this 2 and 2 cancel. This one canceled. The exponent is still 1. So then here we still have n, so let's put n here. So now let's see, as n goes to infinity, inside the bracket, so this part just goes to e. Then this part goes to 2. So that's why the limit as n goes to infinity, just e squared. So e squared is the answer of this limit.